Yeah, hello friends. I welcome you all to the lecture series on discrete mathematics. So in today's session, we will see these four topics: POS form, SOP form, PCNF, and PDNF. Actually, our sole aim is to understand the concept of PCNF and PDNF, but for understanding PCNF and PDNF, we need the concept of POS and SOP. So that's why we will start our discussion from POS and SOP form of representation. So we are starting with POS form representation of a Boolean function. So POS is a short form for product of sum. Product of sum form. So what is product of sum? So definitely we will be having some terms which will be in the form of sum, and those terms will be connected to each other through an operator called the product operator or conjunction operator. In discrete mathematics, we call it conjunction. As for example, suppose we are having three variables, or better to say three propositions, x1, x2, and x3. Now, this x1, x2, and x3 are the three variables or three propositions. Now, if we want to write it in POS form, means one of the POS forms, if we want to write it down, then we can write it like this: x1 bar or x2 or x3. This is one term in which the variables are connected using disjunction operation. Variables are connected using disjunction variables. So sum is there. Now, similarly, we are having another term. As for example, it may be x1 or x2 bar or x3 bar, like this. And what we have to do, we have to finally connect these two terms using product operation. Okay, so in discrete mathematics, we write product like this, and this is called the conjunction operator. This is called the conjunction connective, right? So this is one POS representation. This is one product of sum representation. Product of sum representation means some sums are there. This is sum one, this is sum two. And these two sums are connected to each other using conjunction, using AND operation, using product operation. So that's why this is called POS representation. Now, suppose we are having three variables, and if I am writing x1 or x2 and x2 or x3 bar, is it a POS representation? Yes, it is a POS representation. Why? Because this is a term in which variables are connected through the sum operator, through OR operator, through disjunction operation, right? And this is sum two. And these two are connected using the product operation. So that's why this is also a POS form. This is also a POS representation. But there is a difference between these two. What is the difference? The difference is that here in first example, all the three variables are present in each of the term. We are having two terms, sum one and sum two. In both sum one and sum two, all the three variables, x1, x2, and x3 are present. But here in example number 2, we can see that in sum 1, x1, x2 is present while x3 is missing. Similarly, in sum 2, x2 and x3 is present, but x1 is absent. So this is the basic difference between these two. And finally, this is called this one term, this sum 1 and sum 2, these terms are called the max term. These terms are called the max term. So here we are having, this is a max term. This is a max term. But what about this second case? No, this is not a max term. Why this is not a max term? The reason is, to be a max term, all the variables should definitely be present. So this is not a max term, as x1, x3 is not present. This is also not a max term. The reason is x1 is absent here. So this is not a max term. Okay. So this is the difference between these two. And we are, in case of PCNF and PDNF, we are interested for those terms in which all the variables are present. In which all the variables are present. So we are interested for this first case. We are very much interested for this first case. Okay. Now another form. Means, although second case is also a POS form, both are POS form, but first one is called a POS form, exclusive class of POS form, in which all the terms consist of all the variables present. Only three variables are here. That's why, see here, in sum one term, we are having three variables. In sum two term, we are having three variables. Even if sum three term will be there, then also there we will be having three variables. So it should definitely be present. If it is not present, it is not going to be a max term. Okay. Now I am coming to the concept of SOP form. So SOP form means sum of product. Sum of product means we will be having some product terms. We will be having some product term and we have to sum up them. Means they will be connected by OR operator. They will be connected by disjunction operator. So we will be having the product form. So suppose example, again, x1, x2 and x3, three propositions or three variables are there in an event. Then x1 and x2 bar and x3, this is one term. It is connected to another term with OR operator, and that another term will again contain these three variables. So suppose it is x1 and x2 and x3 bar. So here again we can see that in product 1 and product 2, all the three variables are present. In product 1 and in product 2, all the three variables are present. So if this is the case, then we call it mean terms. Then this is called a mean term. This is called a mean term. This is also a mean term. So now suppose a case where we are having three variables are there, x1, x2, x3, but we are having the term in this form, x1 and x2 bar or x2 bar, x2 bar and x3 bar. Suppose this is the case. Is it in SOP form? Yes, this is in SOP form, but these terms will not be called as mean terms. What is the reason behind it? Behind that? because I have already stated that in min term or max term, all the variables present in the scenario, in the question, should definitely be present. So here we are having three variables, but in this we are seeing that we are having in this product one and product two, only two variables are present. In product one, x1 and x2 are present, x3 is missing. In product two, x2 and x3 are present, x1 is missing. So this is an example of SOP form, but P1 and P2 are not mean terms. Why? Again, I repeat, the reason to be mean term is, the reason not to be the mean term is because in P1 and P2, some of the variables which are there in the question, they are missing. But according to the definition of mean term, all the variables be definitely mandatorily present in all the terms. If that is not the case, you're not going to get a mean term or a max term. So this is about POS and SOP form. And it is very useful in understanding the concept of PCNF and PDNF. It is very important to understand the concept of PCNF and PDNF. Now, we'll try to understand about PCNF. So let's see what PCNF is. PCNF. PCNF stands for Principal Conjunctive Normal Form. Principal Conjunctive Normal Form. Now, what is Principal Conjunctive Normal Form? Just the formal definition of Principal Conjunctive Normal Form is a Boolean expression . A Boolean expression is said to be in PCNF if it is the conjunction of max terms. Okay. The very first example that we have seen in case of POS form was nothing but the example of PCNF. As for example, suppose I'm writing X or Y or Z. And X bar, Y, or Z bar. So here in the question, we are having three variables, X, Y, and Z. We are having three variables, X, Y, and Z. Now, this representation we have already seen that this representation is called POS representation. We have already seen POS representation. Why? Because this is sum 1, this is sum 2. These are two different terms and they are connected using the connective AND. So that's why this is product of sum form. This is product of sum form. And apart from that, we can see that these are max terms also. These are max terms. This is a max term. Okay, so a Boolean expression will be said in PCNF if it is the conjunction of max term. Yeah, these two are the max term and we are having a conjunction operation between these two max term. So definitely it is going to be in PCNF form. So this is a PCNF form. This is a PCNF form. But suppose just assume a case that if this is the situation xy and x bar y and z bar, is it in PCNF form? So just we will understand, we are having three variables x, y and z. This is in POS form, no problem. This is in POS form. Why? Because it is in product of some form. This is one sum, this is another sum, and they are connected using the AND operator, conjunction operator. So definitely it is product of some form, POS form. But whether it is in PCNF form? No. The answer is simply no. Why? Because this term consists of only two variables, only two proposition x and y. That's why this is not in PCNF form, because this is not going to be a max term. This is not a max term. This is not a max term. Why this is not a max term? Because the variable z is missing here. The variable z is missing here. Okay, we are having three variables x, y and z, and z is missing here. That's why it is not going to be a max term. Rather, it is a max term. This is a max term. But since this is not a max term, it is not going to be a PCNF. So not in PCNF. Okay. So I hope the concept of PCNF is clear. Now we will understand about PDNF. Coming to PDNF. So the full form of PDNF is principal disjunctive normal form. Principal disjunctive normal form. So coming to the formal definition of PDNF. A Boolean expression is said to be in PDNF if it is the disjunction of min terms. Means here min terms will be there and they will be connected using the disjunction operation. OR operation. Okay, just we'll see one example. Suppose we are having three variables. Suppose we are having three variables x, y and z, and we are writing x bar, y bar and z bar or x, y bar, z. Now the question is whether it is a PD, is it in PDNF form or not. We'll see it. There are two different terms. This is called term 1 or product 1 and this is product 2. In both the terms we can see that we are having all the three variables present, x, y and z. They may be present directly or they may be present in their negation form. It is accepted, but all the three should be present. So that's why this is in SOP form, sum of product form. This is in sum of product form. And apart from that, this is in PDNF form also. This is in PDNF form also. Why? Because PDNF says that if it is the disjunction of min terms. Yeah, is this a min term? Yeah, this is a min term. Why this is min term? Because we have already seen the concept of min term. That if the propositions or the variable given in the question are connected through the conjunction operator, then it is called a min term. So here three variables are there, x, y and z, and x, y and z are connected through the conjunction operator. That's why it is a min term. Similarly, this is also a min term, and these two min term are connected using the disjunction operator. So that's why this form is in PDNF form. Now suppose we are having three variables and we are considering a case as x1 and y bar we are having three variables x y and z so we are considering the case x and y or y bar and z bar so is it in SOP form yes it is in SOP form why because these are the two products products x and y bar and z bar and they are connected through a sum operator a disjunction operator so that's why this is in SOP form this is a SOP form we agree but what about PDF PDNF form so since there are three variables and we are having two terms here and in both the term we are seeing that one of the variable is missing here in term 1 the variable which is missing is z and here in term 2 the variable which is missing is x so that's why if that is the case if any of the variable is missing in any of the term then it cannot be a PDNF so this is not a PDNF not in PDNF form so in the next lecture we will solve one example in which we will be asked to find the PCNF and PDNF form for a given Boolean function so I hope till here everything is clear thank you very much